Hello students, hope you are safe and healthy. This is Chaitra here, your computer teacher. So I'll be handling your computer whole year. So well, let us see about the basics of computer programming. So the contents you are going to learn in this year is problem solving using computer, overview of C language, operators in C language, input and output statements in C language, decision making and looping, arrays, character string and additional programs. So I have divided into three parts here. So first part A contains definition of a computer language. Before learning any language, you need to know what is a computer language. Then why we are learning this computer language is the second question. And next is what are the types of languages, that is low level language and high level language, and some of the standalone and web based applications. So the for writing any language, you need either it can be a standalone application or a web based application. Then why C language? So why we need to learn C language? So in part B, I'll tell you about the system analysis, algorithm, features and characteristics of an algorithm, then notations of algorithms and flowchart. So these are the major things for writing any program. So for writing any programming, we need system analysis. First, we need to analyze what is the scenario. Then we need to make an algorithm. Then we need to write the features, or we need to write the notations. Then the flowchart comes. Then let us, in part C, I'm going to teach you about the programming logic, then number system, conversions of number system and exercises. Next is chapter 1, that is basics of computer programming, that is part A. So let us now see what is a language. The language is a method of human communication, either written or spoken. You know, language is very necessary for the persons to talk. Then examples, Hindi, Telugu, Kannada, English, or any, there are many other languages. So this is the, there are many other languages. So I have taken some of the examples here. So the person who doesn't know Hindi can't converse properly. So with other person who knows Hindi. So here there should be some language. So if he knows English and other person also know English, so it's better we can talk it in the English and we can share some information. So again, the computer language. So whatever the computer is, even it need to talk with each other, right? So here talking is some sharing some informations or sharing some resources. There is one system and there is another system. Some files are there in the first system and some files are there in the second system. So this first system need to access some files. So it has to need to communicate with the second system. So examples, Java, Basic, C, C++, etc. There are many programming or many languages, computer languages. So it's nothing but a system language to share files, information or resources. So next, computer language consists of set of programs. Hope you know what is programs. So programs are nothing but a set of instructions given to computer to do this. Okay, so we also have some instructions, right? Early in the morning when we get up, we need to follow some instructions. So while coming to school, we need to follow some instructions. So here computer also need to follow some instructions. For that we are writing some programs. So set of instructions given to do computer to particular task. For example, to do addition, you need two numbers. You can't do addition with the same single number, and the result has to be shown. So you need to say, take one number, take two number, add, and then give me the result. So these are some of the instructions we are going to tell to the computer to do. Otherwise, you know, computer is a dummy machine. It does not know what to do. So we are the persons who are giving some instructions to the computer. So next, how do you think we communicate with the computer? So computer, so we are the human being, so we need to communicate with the computer, right? So a computer cannot understand any commands that you may give in the English or in any other language. That is definitely a true, because whatever if you say to the computer, please do it, it will not, because it does not understand our English language. So it has its own set of instructions for communication. So it has its own set of instructions that we need to give, or what we call as computer languages. So the user of the computer must be able to communicate with it. So we are the persons, we are called as users, we are using the computer, and we need to learn the instructions that we can give it to the computer, or we need to learn the computer languages so that we can give instructions to the computer and get our work done. That means he must be able to give computer commands and understands the output that computer generates. So if you give some commands, if you give add, then it will understand what is add and then it will add. So if you don't give anything, then the computer does not know what it should be done. So basically there are two main categories of computer languages, mainly low level languages and high level languages. Normally what we are using these days are high level languages. So you can see some of the examples here. So Java. So Java is a programming language, Ruby, C Sharp, then PHP, C++, Python, Perl, Visual Basic, C programming, JavaScript, etc. So these are some of the languages. Next, let us discuss about low-level languages. So low-level languages are the basic computer instructions or better known as machine codes. So low-level languages are the languages which are basically, it's very near to the computer. A computer cannot understand any instruction given to it by user in English or any other high-level language. So if you say in English, please bring me a cup of coffee, the computer cannot understand. So you need to tell in its own language. They are the nothing but the machine codes. These low level languages are very easily understandable by the machine. So the main function of low level language is to interact with the hardware of the computer. You know, there are some hardware devices. So the main function of low level language is to interact with the hardware of the computer, hardware devices. They help in operating, syncing and managing all the hardware and system components of the computer. You know, it helps, the operating system is the main thing for the computer to start its work. So this helps in the operating system development as well as syncing. Syncing is nothing but there should be some synchronization between the hardware devices and the computer, or you can just call it as there should be some sync between the hardware devices and the software devices. Then managing all the hardware system. So it should manage all the hardware system, because for a working of the computer, you know, all the hardware systems are also important. Next, let us learn about the machine language and the assembly language. So low level languages are classified into two types here. One is the machine language, another one is the assembly language. This is one of the most basic low level language. The language was first developed to interact with the first generation computers. Hope you know generations of computers. So if you don't know the generations of computers, please go and learn the first generation, second generation. So the first generation, they use normally the vacuum tubes. So for this they use machine languages. So it is written in the binary code or a machine code. So a binary code is either written in zeros or ones. So all the English, whatever we call ADD, that was developed into zeros and ones. That is ones and zeros. So this was very near to the computer to understand. Next is the assembly language, the second generation programming, which use the transistors. They use the second generation, that is assembly language. It is developed on the machine language, where instead of using only numbers, we use English words, names and symbols. So they use, instead of using ones and zeros, why? Because it became very difficult for a human being to write the program in the machine language. So all the sentences cannot be converted to zeros and ones, and he cannot, like, writing the program was very difficult. So he could not remember so much of zeros and ones, and again when the same instruction came, so again he was in a confusing state what should be done. Anyway, human brain is not so, don't have so much of capacity to learn so much of, remember so much things. So they developed assembly language. For example, for ADD, they use some English words like add, sub, or mul, MUL for multiplication, DIV for division, so that these were converted to machine code. It is the most basic computer language necessary for any processor. Next, let us learn about high-level language. So when we talk about the high-level language, these are the programming languages. Some prominent are Pascal, Fortran, C++, etc. So you have heard many high-level languages. The important feature about such high-level language is that they allow the programmer to write programs for all types of computers and systems. So the major advantage here is the programmer can write programs for all types of computers. You know, there are different types of computers. There are laptops, there are palm tabs, there are analog computers, digital computers. So you can write the program for all the computers as well as all the systems. And also it is more main in the English language, that is understandable by the human. So every instruction in the high level language is converted to machine language for the computer to come. So whatever we are going to write, it would convert to the machine level language. So it can be classified into three types: scripting language, object oriented, procedure programming language. So please don't just see about what is scripting language, what is object oriented, and what is procedure. So scripting languages or scripts are the essential programming languages. These languages employ a high level construct which allows it to interpret and execute one command at a time. So this script, you know, it is already generally, it is always there. So you need to just take it and you need to just execute it. So scripting languages are easier to learn and execute than compiled languages. So instead of writing every time the instructions, there is some script already ready there. So you need to just write those script and then you need to execute. Then next comes the object-oriented languages. We called OOPS, object-oriented programming structure. So these are the high-level languages that focus on objects rather than the action. So there will be some objects. Suppose suppose we are going to do all the four things in a single thing, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. All these four things are in a particular object. So we just take that particular object and we will see according to our dependency, whether we need to add the numbers, or whether we need to divide the numbers, or whether we need to subtract the numbers, or whether we need to multiply the numbers. So this forms the object. So whenever there is some problem, you can directly just attack the objects, not the particular actions. Hope you understood this. Again, I'll just brush it up. So all these four: addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, I'll just make an object called as numbers. So in that numbers, you'll get addition, you'll get subtraction, you'll get multiplication, as well as you get a division. So these are the actions: addition, subtraction, multiplications and division. So I'll just attack numbers there. I'll not say what it should be done. So whenever there is some changes, I'll just take out the numbers objects. So this reason behind is that programmers really care about the objects they wish to manipulate rather than logic needed to manipulate. Some examples include Java, C++, C++, Python, Swift, etc. Next comes the procedural programming language. This is a type of programming language that has well-structured steps and complex procedures within its programming to compose a complete program. So they have some procedure. You need to follow that particular procedure. So here, however, you in object oriented, you can create your own objects. Whereas in procedure programming languages, you need to follow the procedure. So suppose you need to do something, you need to follow from the beginning. So this was like very complex. Complex part of writing the programmings. So why? Because you need to follow from the starting. You can't take it out in the middle and you can't do some objects, or you can't create your own and make it little less nothing. So you need to just follow the particular procedures. It has a systematic order functions and commands to complete a particular task. So whenever there is some task, you need to follow some procedures. Without that procedures, you can't write the program. So Fortran, Algol, Basic, COBOL, they are some of the procedure programming languages. Next, languages can further be divided into standalone and web applications. So hope you don't know what is standalone and web application. So here I'll tell you what is standalone. Need to be installed. So standalone applications are the applications or a software which need to be installed to the system. So you can't directly work on it. You need to first install, then you need to see whether it's compatible to the particular OS, that is operating system, and then you can work on it. So compatible for the single operating system. Suppose I have a Windows operating system and I need to install a C language. Then I should see whether the Windows operating system is compatible with the C editor, and then I can install on the system to work on the C language. Otherwise, I can't just work on the C language. So they are called as standalone softwares or standalone applications. Examples: MS Office or the Microsoft Office, then your Java, C, C++. All these are standalone applications. So you need to just install it and then you need to work on it. So now let us see what is web applications. No need to install. So you just need not install it. It is independent of the operating systems. It can work on any other operating systems. Example, Facebook, your Google. So they are nothing but the web applications or a web softwares which can be worked. It is independent of the operating system. So you can just install Facebook on the Windows also. You can just install Facebook on the Android also. You can just, I don't know about the Linux or any other things. You can just install it. It is independent. Next, let us see what is programming language. So there are some programming languages. I have taken some programming languages here. So this is C, C++, Java, .NET and Android. So these are the programming language which needs to be installed to the system to work on. So there are two, that is C, C++ are platform dependent standalone applications. So what is platform dependent? So platform dependent is, if you install in that particular system, you need to work in that particular system. So you can't just take your C program and you can't work in some other system which are there in far away. So you need a, that is platform dependent. So if you in your home PC, if you install C, then you need to work in the C only. So if your other system does not have any C, then you need to install it and then you need to use. So then Java, .NET and Android are platform independent and can be used as standalone or web applications. So Java, .NET and Android. So what we are using now, Android, they are the platform independent. So if you install Java in my system, so you want to use a Java in other system, that you can use it. So next .NET also, then Android. So these are some of the programming languages. For example, I have taken it. So now let us see why we need a C language. So C language, being the middle level language, reduces the gap between the high level language and the low level language. One more question arises. So what is the use of learning this C language? There are many other languages. Still we need to learn C language. Why? So all the embedded systems like electronic devices still use language, C language today. So all your fridge, washing machines which have embedded systems inside are programmed using C language. And the C++ is the best gaming library. So whatever the games you are using now are done using C++ language. So Java and .NET are in the enterprise level or banks, insurance. For example, if you take ICICI Bank, so it is an international bank and all the transactions cannot be done from one place. So many other places you need the transactions to be done. So they use normally the Java because it should not be a platform dependent. It should be a platform independent. So you can use that program anywhere else and it can be accessible to any other persons also. So including doing some insurance software or any bank software, you can use Java and .NET. So some questions I have put here. A computer program is a, you need to write the questions or you can just tell orally. So what is a computer program? What is a programming language? Then levels of programming language. You know, there are two types of levels of programming language. That is high level language and low level language. Then two low level languages, any two low level languages with example, and any three high level languages with example. Next, another one question is there for you. Programming languages, ear developed and full form. So there are some programming languages I have given here. Fortran, COBOL, Basic, C, C++, SQL and VB. You need to just tell me when, in which year they were developed and you need to tell me what is the full form of this. And one more slide, this is the major important slide for you. So this is the programming language, popularity of use of the programming language and practical applications of the languages. You may tell why we need to learn these programming languages, what are the uses. So these are some of the practical applications that we are using in the daily life. So first is Java, which is in the top one popular. So it is used for desktop GUI applications, whatever you're going to do, online shoppings, internet banking, then mobile application, gaming software. Java, the programming language, is used in all this application. Next comes the popularity C. So it is mainly used to develop the operating systems, embedded systems, database management systems, your compiler, gaming and animations. Next is Python, which is in the third. It is used for machine learning, artificial intelligence. Now what is the era? Is artificial intelligence era. So here the main this thing is Python. Hope you have heard Python. Python, they'll say Python. So what Python is also a programming language used to develop mainly for the artificial intelligence. All the programs now in artificial intelligence are written in the Python. So face detection and image recognition. So nowadays the mobile phone, there is a face recognition. So how it is written? It is written in the Python programming language for Androids. Next is C++, banking, all your trading, virtual machines and compilers. Next is Visual Basic, Windows servers, control libraries, web applications, all these are developed using Visual Basic. Next is C#, desktop applications like your file explorer, whatever the Word we use, whatever the Excel we use, web browsers, all these are developed using C#. So JavaScript, client side and server side validation, then PHP, static and dynamic websites application, server side scripting. So you know what is static and dynamic websites? So the static websites are the websites where the information remains as it is. Dynamic websites are the websites where the information change in each second. For example, your stock market site. So each minutes or each second the information changes. So they are nothing but the dynamic websites. So PHP is used normally in that. So PHP software or PHP programming is used in that. Then SQL is mainly used for querying database, and C. Objective-C is used for Apple, iOS operating systems, everything. So this will be a very useful for your this thing. Thank you, children.